Evening, how you doing? Welcome to Drinks and Design Podcast, brought to you by Down the Shore Marketing. Local marketing for all your local needs.
That's right.
I'm CJ.
Robert. This is Ashish.
And tonight we're here to talk about keeping our guacamole straight and some Halloween beers and some kosher beers, unrelated. So we're going to talk about some different beers we have for Halloween, IPAs, and some other ones that are for there for kosher. So let's start off with Stonewall.
Okay, Robert. Sounds good. Robert, it's your Stonewall first.
Right, we got the Stonewall in.
Yes, yes.
It's beautiful beer that is
show the logo?
Packaged here in Brooklyn, and it's got a grapefruit base. Ooh, yes.
Get a cup, please, Ashish.
Here we go.
Let's
fruity grapefruit.
Uh-huh. Is there any
soak that
to
glass
it?
A little bit.
Nice. Just sip because we're going to do that. Six more to go.
Yes. Okay.
Going to be a long night. Mm-hmm. All right.
Don't drive home through Allenhurst.
We are going to try a beer now that neither of us have ever tried.
Session IPA from Brooklyn. Okay.
It is.
Cheers.
Fully kosher, certified.
Certified kosher.
And we are going to be kosher now and tasting it.
Mm-hmm. Mm, nice bouquet.
It does have a nice...
It's beautiful. It smells beautiful.
Like it's very...
it's very
expansive.
Tropical, right?
Yeah.
It's very tropical. It takes me to the Dominican Republic for some reason.
Mm. Hey, it's Brooklyn Brewery. The logo is okay. Almost like the Coca-Cola logo.
Like an LGBTQ thing, right?
Well, it's good. Right. It's diverse. It's
diversity.
LGBTQIA+.
Very Brooklyn. Yes.
Actually, it depends on what kind of Brooklyn.
5.0 ABV.
Yes.
It's a nice, easy drinking IPA. I mean, I think most IPAs I struggle with, but this one is actually pretty smooth.
Yeah. Well, right? I think the grapefruit.
Tell us again about the history of IPA.
Indian Pale Ale. Again, we discussed this a few episodes ago. So happened that the British used to bring in beer from England into India because India was not producing beer. Most Indians didn't know what beer was. So they began getting it in, but it just gets spoiled. And a lot of the beer that was drunk back then was lighter beer, generally speaking. So they decided to make it heavier so it would last longer on the journey. And that is the reason why you have this beer, which is relatively heavier, has more spices and tropical fruit and things like that. And that's the origins of an IPA. And here we are having a version of IPA right here in Brooklyn and right here in New Jersey.
It's very refreshing.
I thought they had one of the ingredients, so they had to use something else.
Yeah, well, the main reason why they did this is because the beer wouldn't keep well, the light beer.
Okay.
It wouldn't keep well to the 6-month journey. Okay. On a ship, so there's no way they could transport it. They had to add stuff to it, mm-hmm. and they added German hops, and Germany was not too far away, so that was easy. They dunked it in, made it much more heavier. Same thing goes for wine. Wine is the same problem. You have lighter wine, doesn't transport very well. Heavier wine, not a problem.
Okay, I know that.
Same story.
Remember you tell it saying they didn't have barley in India, so they used lots more hops. That's where they got the IPA.
I don't think so. We do make barley, but it's not like anywhere close to what Europe produces.
Yeah, so like they didn't have it, so they do double up on hops.
That could be too.
That seems to make a lot of sense.
Last time.
Yeah, that could be.
Great. Mm-hmm. So, Robert, want to get your second beer? See what it's like?
All right, let's go to the second one.
Blue Moon.
The Blue Moon Mango Wheat. Blue Moon Mango Wheat. Mm. All right.
Yes, and unlike most Blue Moons that we are more familiar with, which have a grapefruit base. This is a mango wheat. What is it? 5.4% alcohol.
Slightly higher than this one.
And same as the other one, I think, actually. So it'll be an interesting taste. I've always enjoyed Blue Moon, the regular Blue Moon that we are all used to. This will be a different taste altogether, the mango wheat. So
all right.
Are we ready to indulge?
We are ready.
All right.
The Blue Moon logo is okay, but it does a simple technique where it tries to combine upper and lower case together. The U in the blue for Blue Moon is a lowercase, which is kind of annoying to me, but that's their logo and they can do what they want. But I like how the swoosh of the blue moon goes across the actual moon that's blue.
Yes, that's and a beautiful thing.
Big. Although it's kind of difficult to see. The orange isn't very even in the color there.
That's like a weird orange, right? It's like a fluorescent orange almost.
It's almost it's yellowy.
Yellowish,
more than
yeah.
orange.
Yeah, yeah, it's an interesting little...
You gotta get better quality control down the printers.
It does smell of mango. Mm-hmm. And good. It definitely smells like a weed beer. It has that...
So it smells like mango. Does it have mango in it?
I think there'll be some flavors, right?
Yeah, it's
and if we're pregnant, we shouldn't drink it. So we're okay drinking it.
So far, so good. I mean, who knows by the end of the evening.
Uh-oh.
No, this is a nice brightness. Ingredients. Right? This is a nice...
It's a nice taste.
Brightness. It's almost like a lager. Mm. A wheat can of wheat beer. Not a lager, but it has a brightness that I don't see in the IPA out here.
Yeah.
But the IPA is down here.
Right.
This one is like up
it's more
there,
expressive.
Nice
it's more, you know, bold. Not bold. It's more... Well, it's more fruity, actually, I think.
Definitely, yeah. Lighter, definitely. Fruitier.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely mango, of course.
Mango-ier.
Better be mango. Yeah.
The Blue Moon marketing mix is very good. They have a good mix of different social media. The website's good. The logo is solid. They use the logo, the colors, and the typeface permeates all of their marketing material. The website's really good. Pardon me.
They're a really established brand,
my
right?
My guacamole is off-center.
Oh, yes.
And so it carries through on their Facebook presence, on their Instagram presence. Mm. And they haven't gone into TikTok yet because it's for kids, I guess. So it works pretty well and it's pretty solid.
And you do mean that the beer is for kids, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, not the TikTok is for kids.
But no, I actually like that. I might have this at the beach club.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I keep them on all the time.
It's right? A summery taste.
It's a summery taste, yeah.
Tropical, beautiful, fun summer.
Okay. Given that we're in fall right now with the Halloween theme and everything, this is a nice surprise element here.
Yes.
It's shooting me back to summer.
And considering that our fall in October
well, it's still
is
October,
75 degrees.
Let's start with Oktoberfest beer.
Ooh, Oktoberfest. Yes,
is it Shiner Oktoberfest beer? Shiner is a pretty big company. You can also tell because I couldn't find an actual... website for the Oktoberfest beer. It's all part of the Shiner presence. Mm. They do
is
have
a
Facebook
German
presence.
Beer?
They do have a pretty good social media presence. What they did was they probably saved money by not making a whole new website for it, by just making it part of their main website.
Oh.
And then
is it the German
updating
company?
It through, yes, it is. Oh,
okay.
Updating it through their social media.
Well, Germans are stingy, I have to say.
What?
Nice color. I'll tell you that.
I'm good.
Oh, it's because we have like six.
Nice color.
Oh my God, this reminds me of whiskey.
Yeah.
Right?
This is a fun beer. I like the logo. I like
the
orange and the blue work well together. The obviously, they use a grotesque typeface, which is okay.
Yeah, wow.
It's pretty rote.
So but, totally different.
The printing on the labels is good, much better than the Blue Moon, as you can tell.
Very old school fonts, right, going on here.
Typefaces, mm-hmm. Yes.
They're kind of talking back to the... grand old days of Oktoberfest.
Oh, it works.
Of
Germany.
Yeah, Germany.
It's solid.
Yeah.
They don't overdo it. They don't try to put lots of other grotesque.
Mm-hmm.
The grotesque is the typeface that was the first real sort of second or third real
grotesque.
German typeface before they started using Helvetica. And it was, even so, during World War II, the Nazis made grotesque typeface illegal. But then the law that said the grotesque was illegal to use was written in grotesque. So it's kind of weird.
That's why it's grotesque.
But,
wow.
The beer's pretty good, pretty solid. I like how it's a full body and it keeps its foam. It's nice.
It doesn't smell like much, though. That's the funniest thing. Because the previous two beers, like, have this
had
thing coming at your face.
But
right.
I think
this
the other two beers have a lot of artificial, natural flavors in it.
Probably. This has nothing, probably.
Because the Blue Moon doesn't even have ingredients. Your guess is as good as mine. You need to throw some shit in there.
Oh my God.
But it works. It's good beer. It's not a good beer you have to have five of, like a Coors Light. It's good. My guacamole is off center still.
I don't know what to make of this, guys. I mean, this beer is kind of
It's like a real beer.
Yeah.
It's a real beer?
Exactly. Exactly.
I'm not stressed what the other one is.
the other two that we've just had were like designer beers.
Designer beers.
It's like when you go, her breasts, they feel funny. Oh, that's because they're real. Mm. Mm. So try your cone head now, man?
Cone head.
Cone head it is, okay.
Right up from SNL.
What is it called, cone head? It says E-head. What is it? Was that right?
The cone head haze.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
So this is another IPA. And it's an IPA that I was trying to drink at the beach. Never gone to it. So here we are.
You're getting dragged through Allenhurst?
Not quite. Seabright, yes.
Seabright's worse.
I know.
And why didn't you get to it, Ashish?
But we didn't have to actually go through the gauntlet. Going through the gauntlet is going over the bridge.
Yeah.
In the Rumson.
Yeah, that's okay. A dangerous one, too. All right, so
I got pulled over on the bridge going into Rumson with four people in the car and one girl in the trunk. And they pulled me over and goes, oh, license registration? Oh, you're Mary Riz, little boy, aren't you? Yep. When you can open up another peninsula house? Anytime soon, sir. All right, carry on, young man.
When was this? Just yesterday?
No, in 87.
So this is a nice.
I just had my permit.
It's a very strong bouquet, right? And it all smells of pine. Really? Mm-hmm. Well, no wonder there's a big.
It's kind of prickly.
It's prickly. It actually has a big, huge pine facing
prickly,
the face.
Yeah.
It's like an IPA. It tastes like it's missing something. Yeah. Barley.
Well, it has hops, malt, the usual stuff. But I think it goes. I think what they've done here is they've mixed old hops with new hops. Old hops are less fruity.
Doesn't it explode?
It should, but it hasn't. It's zero gravity, right?
Okay.
Yes, that's.
Well, the idea is they've mixed two different things together, like the herbal stuff.
Like if you only have a half a glass of skim milk left, half a glass of regular milk left.
There you go.
And
yeah.
When you're looking cookies. And you put your cookie in, and the motherfucker blows up.
There you go.
In a way, for me, it seems like it's not complete. There's something.
IPAs taste that way.
It doesn't have that finish, right? It doesn't have that finish of the base of the palate.
Yeah, IPAs right? Always taste like they're missing something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Guacamole. They're missing guacamole.
So it's not even tropical. It's not completely herbaceous. Somewhere in between, which explains the mix of the hops. And maybe it tastes like guacamole, you're right. This is a man.
Look at him. You can tell right off the bat. Hmm?
Eat tacos.
Eat me.
Look what I have to contend with here between these two. Literally, figuratively, between these two.
Pumpkin Smasher by Big Buddy Brewing Company. Pretty good. This will be a stronger beer. Mm. Their website's pretty good. They even actually have their own URL for the website. And a good social media presence where images, good imagery, not a lot of pictures of people drinking the beer, but a lot of good pictures of the beer, a lot of good pictures of the different logos in action, different logo usages. So it's pretty good.
That's good. This one, by the way, I forgot to mention, but they had a pretty good website too. And this is a company from Vermont, and they're very heavy into sustainability and stuff. Mm-hmm. So they support a lot of the local farmers, blah, 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 which is where they source the pine from.
Okay.
And the hops from. So, something different.
Nice story.
Yeah. It's funny now, even with, when I used to critique websites, I used to always make sure, is the mobile site good? Is the desktop site good? How is it doing different breakpoints? But these are all mobile first, and they're very, very succinct. They're very good. Nothing overlapping, nothing broken. It's good. Video all sinks in pretty well.
Okay, and this is the Pumpkin Smash. What's the company again?
Muddy Brewing Company.
Muddy Brewing, okay.
You can
is it real? I can't tell. It's got good pumpkin-y taste.
It does have a nice pumpkin-y bouquet.
Okay.
To begin with, it smells like pumpkin pie.
Right, it's not like pumpkin. Is that what you said? It's not?
It smells like pumpkin pie.
It smells like it, but it doesn't taste like it.
It doesn't taste like it.
It says best it kept refrigerated. I bought it warm.
Boiled.
In the 80s, Coors came out with this campaign where you got to keep Coors cold. Coors always served best cold. And you'd go to liquor stores and you always see Coors in big piles, not refrigerated. So that really hurt their
feelings.
hurt their marketing because people would turn these commercials. Coors is going to be kept cold. It's going to be kept cold. But it's served cold. And you'd buy big cases of Coors Light warm.
Boiled beer.
Oh, it's all chemically super. Is it super?
Super boost.
Ultra pasteurized.
Ultra pasteurized beer. I like the smell. I mean, this pumpkin pie smell. I'm kind of.
It's fun.
It's fun. But
I couldn't drink a six pack.
It's so seasonal.
No, I just.
But then again, the only thing I drink more than one of the beers here would be the Blue Moon.
Yeah, I know, and that is exactly
the Shiner is too heavy.
Yeah.
This is like drinking pumpkin pie.
And the Conehead would give me headaches.
Yeah. This is like drinking pumpkin pie without the taste.
Yeah. Right? Yes, exactly.
It's kind of a weird kind
like
of.
Like CJ well, said, though, I couldn't drink a whole bottle.
No. This is just.
Well, beer is not really, you're not supposed to drink that much. Only in America they make the beer so watery that we have to have a six pack to get to feel anything. So it's like drinking skim milk. Well, but with beer in Europe, that's also served warm mostly, but it's the heavier beer, it's like a meal, and it's supposed to taste heavy and not make you want to drink for more, unlike American beer.
Although, I've tried Austrian beers, like really light ABV, 2.6%.
Yeah.
Those are really light. They're like, on a hot summer day, oh my God. Mm. Those taste like nectar of the gods. Very light. You can just keep drinking
them.
Are there
hot summer days in Austria?
Well, apparently there are some.
Now
they are.
Thank God for global warming.
Hey. Yes, things are changing as we speak.
Brooklyn is a way to do it. Austrian beer. Anybody's interested. Mm-hmm. All right, so the next one is...
Oh, one thing about... I did it. The Pumpkin Smasher website. It's good. It works both on mobile and on... desktop.
Shipyard?
Mm-hmm. It's called Pumpkinhead.
Pumpkinhead again.
Good.
Little pumpkin country. Anyway.
Shipyard Pumpkinhead. I don't know why Shipyard makes a pumpkin beer. I think kind of like everyone has to have something for every holiday.
I know.
And so Shipyard came out with a pumpkin beer.
It's marketing.
It's marketing. It's like the garment industry, right?
The logo is pretty lame. Yeah, it's not even a serif, but it's all caps. And the
pretty old school,
poor
right?
little horse has his legs cut off.
Uh-oh.
Unlike Pumpkin Smasher, which it has the as a Yeti with some pumpkins.
Okay. With legs. Mm-hmm.
The pumpkins have legs, and the Yeti has legs. But it has all its legs.
I like the aroma on this.
Cheers again.
Gentlemen.
Pinky.
Nice aroma. I like the smell. Mm-hmm.
It's a little more subtle than the pumpkin.
Very similar. It's like a, almost like a stale pumpkin pie.
Well, it's like a beer that has some pumpkin in it versus a pumpkin beer. The Pumpkin Smasher is a pumpkin beer. Like you,
it's obvious.
This is, the Shipyard is a beer that has a hint of pumpkin in it. It's nice.
This is in your face though. Mm-hmm. This is in your face pumpkin. Right, mm-hmm. The taste?
No, it's not, I think. It's
you
not.
Think so?
No, I think it is truly like more subtle.
Mm-hmm. It's a real beer.
In terms of aroma and in terms of taste.
Pumpkin Smasher is more like they took a beer and they put like a pumpkin spice in it.
Mm-hmm. Like yes.
Yeah, pumpkin pie spice, yes.
They took it into Starbucks and said, make this taste like pumpkin.
It's definitely more citrusy.
Okay, because pumpkin isn't really pumpkin. Spice isn't really pumpkin, it's cinnamon and sugar.
Yeah, exactly.
You can cinnamon, sugar, and anything and taste like pumpkin pie.
Yeah. Yeah, but
sewer rat when you get the pumpkin pie. Well, I wouldn't know because I wouldn't eat the pumpkin on the fucking.
All right. How are you doing there, CJ?
Pretty good.
You loving your pumpkins?
I'm almost done. So while I'm finishing, you can have some more of any of these if you like.
Yeah, it's I personally may not drink any of these. They're just not my style. I mean, it's interesting, but.
With the cone head.
Too piney for me. I bought it. It's too piney for me.
Get shit that you like. Try stuff.
Let me see. I think the mango wheat
is good. Floating down. Sorry.
I like the actual, I like the Oktoberfest. The
Oktoberfest? Yeah. Okay, Shiner. Yeah. Yeah, Blue Moon might be the one that I might go for. Mm-hmm. At least
I had the Blue Moon until I read the ingredients, and I like the Shiner.
Mm-hmm. Oktoberfest. That's a real Oktoberfest. But I like mango. That's the reason why.
Soul Train. Rainbow.
I like that whole motif going on. Mm-hmm. The Soul Train, LGBTQ kind of thing going on.
but we probably shouldn't have saved it for last. But this is the strongest one we have.
Okay.
Called Toxic Earth.
Toxic Earth.
It's got a picture of Cthulhu on the front, because we all like Cthulhu. And logo's kind of cool. All caps, got a fade. It's got a good illustration.
What's that alien out there?
That's Cthulhu.
That is Cthulhu, okay.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of fantasy series is that?
Cthulhu is like a English demon, like H.P. Lovecraft.
Kind of. Oh, that kind of stuff, okay. Mm-hmm. H.P. Lovecraft.
Yeah, it's green.
Oh my God.
Perfect.
It's green. It's green.
Wow.
It's green. Green beer.
Mm-hmm.
Could that be a first for me?
It's like St. Patrick's
Day. For me as well. Just guys, see how it all goes.
See when...
It looks like a...
Mr. Lovecraft
looks like
universe.
We took a bar rag and squeezed it out.
Whoa.
Is it toxic enough for you?
It tastes like I'm eating Play-Doh.
Wow. Is this off the wall?
It's a double Indian pale ale, whatever the hell that is. Oh, brew with local honey.
Where are we getting the green?
What kind of it's local somewhere.
This is crazy.
Wow.
Actually, I didn't go. I should go. Got to go to abominationbrewing.com.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Well,
I think it's apropos. From Toxic Earth.
It's got a poison dart frog on it.
If we survive this, wow.
Yeah.
Anything goes.
We're going to Allenhurst.
Oh my God.
Extreme magic
in a handbasket.
I do love the
logo.
The logo
is
fabulous.
It's kind of funky, yes. I mean, I'll give you that. I mean,
the actual logo sucks. It's just an all caps,
yeah,
condensed typeface.
Yeah.
Sensor.
And plus,
so pumpkin head.
Beer's green.
The Shiner is okay, but the Shiner is kind of overdone with the grotesque. The Brooklyn Lager has a good, it has like the...
old school.
It's got the good Soul Train rainbow logo.
Yes.
Toxic Earth is pretty good. It does look like...
Toxic.
It did fall off the Toxic Avenger.
I say you, boys.
The Blue One's got really cheap printing. The Pumpkin Smasher's got the good Yeti on. That's pretty good. The Pumpkin Head, that's kind of a half-assed aftermarket logo. But
Toxic Earth didn't do it for me.
Yeah, sure. That was a little bit scary.
Yeah.
It's it like, looks like...
It's like a beer you get on a dare.
I wouldn't even describe it as a beer. I mean, it's...
It's like a Gatorade gone wrong.
it's like a fermented... Like when they showed like the natives, like they chew up stuff and they spit it out and it went to ferment, and that becomes the stuff they drink. Or like a thing that you give a kid on a dare.
Yes.
Like a suicide. You go behind the bar, you take one little drip of everything.
And you're 17 years of age and you love this stuff.
And then you find girls and you forget about it totally.
And it tastes good.
At that age, anything goes, right?
Exactly. Wow.
So to recap, the best beer I bought, pardon me if that's just my avocado, was the Shiner. That was great.
Fest, okay.
Yep, that was a right. Good little beer. It's that a nice beer. You can have one of them and you feel full and satisfied.
Old school.
It's
the
a
Pumpkin
real
Head
beer.
was my second best beer. It was full body. It didn't have to taste like anything, but you could tell they used pumpkin in it. Although none of them have ingredients, which is kind of creepy. Pumpkin Smasher was okay. It did kind of taste like it came from Starbucks. And on the bottom here, the bottom feeder was Toxic Earth, which was something I got. It could look kind of cool, but I'm regretting finishing it. So,
in fact, you're not going to finish it.
You shouldn't, in my opinion.
Only a sip.
That's what they said.
I think I can sue you. If I get pulled over for drunk driving here, I can sue you.
That is true. Very true.
We can blame it on Toxic Earth. You know?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, Robert. You want to go
Avenger.
Through your choices?
Yeah. As far as the three that I brought, I've got the Stonewall, the IPA.
Mm.
It was okay, but nothing to write home about. I like the logos. I like the graphics. But I'm not crazy about it.
It's kind of like they were just trying to benefit from like being LGBTQIA+.
Yes, kind of a
we need to find out if they're actually doing anything to help
the community. That
Or are they just gay washing?
Using that,
pink washing.
Pink washing.
And then, however, the Blue Moon Mango, which I'm totally unfamiliar with, I like the taste. It's refreshing. It's tropical. It's summery, and I love summer. So anything that can remind me or bring me to summer, in terms of a taste or anything else, is a beautiful thing. Yeah. Mm-hmm. This was a pretty decent beer. I like this quite a bit.
The beer is pretty good. Oh, yeah. Well, we have to find out what's in it. Mm-hmm. Yes. The Blue Moon logo is pretty good. It's a serif type face. It's a good on a swash. It goes across the actual Blue Moon. It's nice. A little on the nose, but the printing of that can is abysmal because it can see it's offset. You can see the white printing over the orange is just it doesn't work.
Yeah, they try to mask it.
Like they're cheap.
Yeah, they could have done a better job for sure. Anything else, Robert, to add?
No, I don't think so. Okay, I think we're good.
I think yeah.
Go ahead, Robert.
Let me get through my final.
What's that logo?
So this is just basically a pine.
It's a pine cone.
It's a pine cone. And
it's supposed to be like a stained glass window pine cone.
You're right. Yeah, it does look like that. You know, very religious almost. Yeah. But I mean, all said and done, this is good. It almost smelled and tasted like pine, which is not exactly very interesting. I like the Shiner.
It tastes like a garden floor.
We keep going back to the Shiner.
The Shiner was good. It was old school. I liked it. It's, you know what you're drinking here. The Storm IPA was also pretty good, very low-key for an IPA, which I like.
All Brooklyn Brewery beers taste the same.
More or less. I think it's part of the whole...
I said that in Brooklyn, Brooklyn Brewery would have like these things where they would sell off extra beer, and it was all these cool logos and stuff, but it was all the same beer. It was just in different packaging.
Maybe that's their game. Trick people. Toxic Earth, didn't like it. Too green for me. The pumpkin stuff is kind of interesting. I mean, one of them was in-your-face pumpkin, the other one was stale pumpkin. Didn't like it. Again,
there's a reason why you don't have pumpkin spice all year round.
Right. There's a good reason why. Blue Moon wins. Very summary, as Robert said.
Blue Moon beats your Shiner?
Yes, it does. I'm sorry, dude. This is it, man. Mango. If there's mango, I'm in love.
But then, it's not mango. It's mango flavor.
It's mango. It's mango, dude.
Okay, hope so.
I may actually have a little. You
it's
guys want
mango flavor?
You know what? Let's finish off with some artificial mango.
All right.
What do you guys think?
Real mango flavor.
This is the way we'll.
Because I can tell you it's in
down the road.
Real vanilla flavor if you like, but you won't like it.
Cheers! Ooh yeah.
Pinky,
mango.
So thank you again from us here at
Down the Shore Marketing.
Down the Shore Marketing
and Design and Drinks
Design Podcast. I'm CJ.
Robert.
And Ashish.
Thank you again, and have a good evening.
Have a good evening. See you soon.
And make better choices than we do.
Keep drinking.